In the early days of large language models, we could provide a model with an input prompt and receive a meaningful response. As we move forward, large language models have evolved to support impressively long input sequences, allowing us to provide them with extensive context for generating answers. However, despite these advancements, there are still certain tasks where large language models struggle, particularly with very long sequences. One such challenge is multi-hop reasoning, which requires the model to connect disparate pieces of information that may be far apart in the text. In this video, we explain a new research paper titled "Writing in the Margins: Better Inference Pattern for Long Context Retrieval." This paper introduces a novel method designed to significantly enhance the performance of large language models on long sequences across various tasks, and they achieve that without a need for any fine-tuning. The method introduced in the paper is called writing in the margins. We will start with a simple, high-level illustration and gradually add more details. To illustrate how it works, we have a large language model, a very long text as context, and an instruction we want the model to address. Now, instead of processing the entire input sequence at once, the writing in the margins method breaks the context into chunks and feeds the context into the LLM by chunks. So the LLM first reads the first chunk and is instructed to write a note about the information in that specific chunk. Then we proceed to read the sequence chunk by chunk and generating notes per each chunk. When done, the LLM classifies for each note whether it has relevant information for the input instruction. For example here, the LLM decided that only the second and the third notes are useful. Finally, both the input context and the meaningful notes are passed to the large language model in order to generate the response for the input instruction. While it may seem that generating all these notes would add significant computational overhead, it actually does not. The LLM inference process typically consists of two main phases. One is the pre-fill phase, where the LLM processes the input prompt and fills the key value cache for the self-attention blocks. When dealing with large sequences, chunked prefill is commonly used to avoid processing the entire sequence at once, which can be memory intensive. The second phase is the decoding phase, where the model generates the response token by token. The key point is that the note generation is integrated into the chunked prefill phase, meaning that when the model processes the first chunk, it generates the first note, while simultaneously filling the key value cache for that chunk. And similarly for the other notes. By the time we reach the decoding phase, the key value cache is already prepared. So the only computational overhead we have is for generating the notes and adding the useful notes into the prompt for the decoding phase. Before moving on, if you're getting value from this content, then please consider subscribing to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. To understand better, let's also review the following figure from the paper. First, at the bottom we see the input instruction is Ethan Washington in a marble-floored room. Above, we have the context divided into chunks in gray. For each chunk, we use a prompt to extract relevant information from that chunk. We see the extracted relevant information on the right, which represent the margins. On the left, we also see that when we process a chunk, it fills the key value cache for that chunk. Finally, we see that the relevant notes are appended to the input context between the context and the instruction. Let's now move on to see the main results from the paper presented in the following table. On the left, we see the 7 models that were used for evaluation, where for each one, the researchers evaluated 3 inference patterns: a standard LLM inference, retrieval augmented generation, and writing in the margins. The researchers curated datasets for 4 benchmarks, with 100 examples per each context length listed in the context title. In the bottom, we have the averages for each inference method on the corresponding dataset. The first 2 benchmarks represent reasoning capabilities, and we can see accuracy improvement ranging between 7% to 10% comparing to standard LLM inference. For the squad benchmark, there is no consistent improvement, and lastly, for the CWE benchmarks, which measures aggregation capabilities, we see an extreme improvement of 30%. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.